Good morning, kids, and welcome back to understand about the human circulatory system. So let's try and understand the size of the heart. So you are supposed to raise your left hand and keep the thumb in and fold it this way, tight fist. And this tight fist is actually giving you the size of your heart. For example, this is the size of my heart. And the same way, it will be the size of your heart, the one you are holding. Tight fist this way, it is exactly the size of your heart at this age. Now, if you just see the structure of this fist, it has this triangular ending. We call it as apex. Heart, actually, this pointed end is exactly in the center of the chest cavity. Exactly in the center. Okay, that means exactly in between the ribs, if you keep, exactly this apex lies in the center. And yes, it is tilted a little bit towards left. I repeat, heart is not located in the left side. Heart is located exactly in the center of the chest cavity, but yes, it is tilted a little bit towards left side. So therefore, I think this myth would have more propagated that heart is located on the left side. Or they say, yes, that is true. They say that left side of the body, that left arm is more important as compared to that of right arm, as far as blood circulation is concerned. What is the reason? Because the pure are oxygenated. Today, after understanding about the circulation of blood in the heart, you will come to know that pure or oxygenated blood actually is being pumped to the left side only. So therefore, they may be thinking that the left side of the body is more important. Actually speaking, all of it is very, very important. Every component is essential for us. So basically, the size, the main pump located in the central cavity, shifted partially towards the left side, and yes, it is giving pure or oxygenated blood to the whole body. Arteries generally carry the pure or oxygenated blood, and then they collect the impure blood from all over body, that is deoxygenated blood that flows in the veins, and it is poured back in the heart. From heart, this impure or deoxygenated blood is sent to the lungs for purification. And in purification process, what happens is that the carbon dioxide is removed and oxygen is inserted in. Like once we had covered about RBCs, I told you that RBCs contain plenty of hemoglobin in them. And each hemoglobin has a capacity to attach 4 molecules of oxygen. That means plenty and plenty, lots and lots of oxygen gets attached to RBCs, and then the blood is sent back to the heart. Listen once again. Pure heart. We begin the story from the term pure heart. This pure blood or oxygenated blood, it starts its journey from heart, goes to the body parts. From body parts, the deoxygenated blood comes back to the heart. Deoxygenated blood or impure blood or the blood carrying more of CO2 is sent to the lungs for purification. And after purification, it is again sent back to the heart. That means heart is the main pumping organ, either collecting impure blood or sending the pure blood to the whole body. That's the responsibility of only heart. One more thing before I start explaining about the circulation of blood in heart. Please understand one thing, that the left lung is a little bit smaller in size as compared to that of right lung. Reason is that only because heart is occupying that part of the chest cavity. It is tilted a little bit towards left side. So therefore, it has shifted or it has reduced the left lung to some extent. So right lung is a bit larger as compared to that of left one. Okay. Now let's understand. Right from, like we had covered in 9th standard about chambers of heart. Small animals will have less number of chambers, and definitely what we call is that there is mixing of blood, oxygenated and deoxygenated in the blood, in the heart. But if there is, you must have heard somebody saying ke is bacche ke dil mein chhed hai, and he or she will be operated after 9 or 10 years of age only. In some cases, if this is so severe, then the child needs to be taken care of initial years of life only. How do they identify? The young one or the newborn may start turning blue. If they start turning blue, that means there is mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood in their heart. That particular core or that hole or that chhed that we say in Hindi, that is actually there in either the walls, the septum that segregates pure and impure, or that may be the case if some valve may be also misfunctioning. Let's understand, beginning with the first one. First thing first, there is this instrument. Nowadays, of course, electronic instruments are available. But you must have seen when you go to the doctor with some of your elders and they put that in the left arm, they ask you to relax and then they start pumping. The mercury level rises up and they say that this is your BP. Your BP is high, your BP is low, blood pressure. The normal blood pressure, of course, we know that is 120/80. This MMHg, we are writing, that means millimeter of mercury. There is a scale wherein it rises up. That actually we are measuring in millimeter of mercury, because mercury is rising up. And here once we write up 120/80, 120 goes for systolic. This is systolic pressure and 80 is diastolic pressure. Now what is the meaning of this? Systole means contraction. When the heart is in contracted form, the pressure is more. And that is what we call as systolic pressure. And when the heart expands, we call it as diastolic pressure. Okay? So definitely once the heart is squeezing, of course the chamber they squeeze. I'm just going to draw the diagram to explain that. When it squeezes, the chamber squeezes, the pressure increases. And that pressure has to be near to 120. Once the heart expands, of course, the pressure falls down. Once the pressure falls down, it comes down to 80. This is one thing. But one simple question to all of us sitting in the classroom and attending. Do we know the name of the instrument that is used to measure blood pressure? What do you call it as?
Sphygmomanometer.
Very good. Very good. I got the responses here. That is sphygmomanometer. Now let's learn the name. See, it's a big one. So you are supposed to learn it in this way. It is known as sphygmo, right? Then mano and meter. That is a blood pressure measuring machine. Now the thing comes, the circulation of blood in human heart. And for that, I'm going to draw a square. That square is there only to understand how the blood flows in the human heart. If at all they are asking you to draw the diagram of heart, that part I'm going to deal tomorrow to teach you how to draw the diagram of heart in a simple way. If you can draw the one that is given in the textbook, that is well and good, but it is a bit difficult. The easier one we are going to take tomorrow. Right now, let's understand about the heart. We say that the heart is basically divided into four chambers. The upper two chambers are known as auricles or atrium. I repeat, auricles or atrium. And the lower chambers are known as ventricles. So auricle or ventricle, atrium or ventricle, it all the way means the same. One very important thing here, if you are talking about heart, then you will find these terms in your textbooks in your side book stating cardiac. XYZ had cardiac arrest, cardiac failure. Cardiac goes for heart. And if they are using the term renal, renal goes for kidneys. Pulmonary, pulmonary goes for lungs. Same way it has been given to all. Continuing with this one, four chambers completely segregated into four parts. And upper two are auricles or atrium. The lower ones are ventricles. This is first thing. Next, we are supposed to write down right and left. And how are we going to do that? See, either you imagine yourself pasted, either you imagine yourself pasted on the diagram. Your right will be the right of the diagram and your left will be the left of the diagram. One way. Second way, if you are writing or drawing this way, then your right automatically will be the left and your left will be its right. See, this is what I meant. I drew this one and now if I feel that I am there on the diagram according to the position of my heart, then this side will be the right side. So this is right auricle and this is right ventricle. This is left auricle and left ventricle. Initially, to begin with, this we are supposed to understand, four chambers completely separated from each other. And of course, between auricle and ventricle, there will be valve, V-A-L-V-E, allowing the flow of blood only in one direction, auricle to ventricle. Okay, that means here we will have valves, this one valve here and one valve here. Because these valves are present between auricle and ventricle, we call these valves as AV valves. AV means aureoventricular or atrioventricular. Aureoventricular valve or atrio. Both means the same. Either of those names, AV goes for both of them. Because this is right atrium or auricle, and this is right ventricle. Accordingly, this is left auricle and this is left ventricle. Remember one thing, both of them are AV valves only. Now, if I start explaining and telling that blood goes from right auricle to right ventricle through AV valve and from left auricle to left ventricle through AV valve, that means I am stating the statement same for both of them. So, there are names given to these AV valves. This AV valve, this side, right auricle and right ventricle, I am labeling them as 1 and 2. If this valve is 1 and this is 2nd, then first AV valve is known as tricuspid valve and second one is known as bicuspid valve. Now why the names are so? What is the meaning of the term cusp? Cusp basically means the hanging flaps of skin, almost like the structure of the skin. They are hanging flaps. If there are three flaps hanging down from auricle towards ventricle, this membrane, if this is called, some part of it is like hanging like this, one, two. If two flaps are there, we call them as bicuspid. And if three of them are there, we call it as tricuspid. So here lies the tricuspid valve and here lies the bicuspid valve. Now let's understand how the blood flows and from where it flows. Impure or deoxygenated blood from all over the body, all over the body. It comes to right organ. Right organ, it is poured through superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Case is not there, so I'm writing it there now. Let's see. It says inferior vena cava and superior vena cava. Why I wrote vena cava, I'm saying, and I'm writing this E in front of it. Whenever in biology you use this E, you mean a plural term. That means more than one. Now, what is the meaning of this superior and inferior vena cava? Superior means above the heart, all impure or deoxygenated blood is collected and it is poured down. That means upper to heart, deoxygenated blood will be collected and poured down in the heart with the help of superior. Above to heart is superior, below to heart is inferior. All the body parts below the heart, from there the impure blood will be collected by veins, and all those veins will pour their impure blood in inferior vena cava. From down below, what about upper side? All the veins will collect and they will pour in superior vena cava. And both of these, they pour deoxygenated blood or impure blood in the right auricle. From right to the auricle, it goes through right cuspid wall to right ventricle. From right ventricle now, it is sent with the help of pulmonary artery, we are going to label in the next diagram as PA. This pulmonary artery will take into the lungs. Pulmonary artery to lungs. Now from the lungs, the pure blood will come, the oxygenated blood will come, and it is poured in the left auricle. And what will bring in here? Here we will have pulmonary veins. They are going to bring and they are going to pour in left auricle. From left auricle it goes to left ventricle, pure blood, oxygenated blood, through bicuspid wall. From left ventricle now, the biggest artery, aorta. A-O-R-T-A, largest artery, will carry the blood from left ventricle to the body parts. So once again, let's understand the story. After drawing this, I'm going to write the ray diagram also here. Ray diagram they asked in the exam, but this diagram is going to make the concept clear from where to where the blood goes. One thing very important, more than auricles, the walls of ventricles are thicker. And that means if you compare auricle and ventricle wall will be thicker. Because from auricles the blood has to simply flow down with gravity, but ventricles have to supply. See carefully, kids, right ventricle has to send it to the lungs. Lungs are nearby, but left ventricle has to send it to the whole body. That means more pressure is required to be generated, and that will be generated with the help of the thicker walls. So yes, one more very important question for exams, like entrance exams, will be that this left ventricle will have even thicker walls. Left ventricle, the walls will be much more thicker than right ventricle. Okay, so let's understand the story once again. inferior blood, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava to right auricle, from right auricle to right ventricle, right ventricle to lungs, from lungs to left auricle, left auricle to left ventricle, and left ventricle to the body parts. This is how the blood flows in the heart. And here you understand one thing very, very important. Right side, as you see, that it carries impure blood, impure or deoxygenated blood. Left side carries all the pure blood. From lungs, here it goes to the body. Now you just see, there is this 3-mark question they ask, 3-mark question they ask at times in the exam. What is double circulation and why it is known as double circulation? The answer in very single line the kids will write down: because the blood flows through the heart twice, therefore we call it as double circulation. It's correct. But then you are supposed to write down in 2 sentences where it exactly flows twice. I repeat again. The circulation in human heart is known as double circulation because blood flows through the heart twice. Same blood, for example, if I'm labeling this as blood V, a blood X, let's say, the same amount, the volume of X blood falls in right auricle. From right auricle, it goes to right ventricle and it is sent to the lungs for circulation. Second circulation, same blood, the X blood, which has been now purified by the lungs, it falls in left auricle. And from left auricle, it goes to left ventricle. And then it is sent to the body parts. What it means? It means very clearly, because the same amount of blood flows twice through the heart, we are calling it as double circulation. But then, as a child of this class, I must be writing in my answer that the first circulation means the blood, the deoxygenated blood from right auricle to right ventricle, and then this into the lungs. Second circulation, oxygenated blood from left auricle to left ventricle, and then it is sent to the body. These 3 sentences will fetch you 3 marks. Don't simply write the first sentence and leave it like that. Okay? Let's draw the ray diagram now. I'll be drawing it on the right side. And I am going to use now the shorter terms here. This ray diagram is asked many a times. Same thing I am going to do right here. That means I will begin my story with right auricle to right ventricle, and that goes to tricuspid wall, and from right ventricle it goes to the lungs through pulmonary artery. From lungs, it comes down to left auricle, from left auricle to left ventricles, and left ventricle to the body parts. Left ventricle, body parts, and from body parts to again right auricle. Now we are going to write down some additional details to it. Here, tricuspid wall, right ventricle to pulmonary artery. See, this pulmonary artery and veins, they have semilunar valves. Those control the backflow of blood. Okay, but important words to read about is about these AV walls, tricuspid and bicuspid wall. And from here it goes to the lungs, and from lungs it is transported to left auricle with the help of pulmonary vein. From left auricle it goes to left ventricle through by a split wall. And from left ventricle to the body part, it goes through aorta. In some of the books, you will write, find it as written as dorsal aorta. It means all the way same because this aorta of the largest artery is present at the dorsal side of the heart. And from body parts, it is going to right auricle with superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. So these terms, once you are mentioning it in this way, the full forms of it must be very clear to us. Once again, so the blood flow, because it is flowing twice through the heart, we are calling it as double circulation. First circulation in the right side, the second circulation in the left side. So this is again a 2 or 3 mark question it has been asked for, and they may ask you to draw the ray diagram, and this will be the ray diagram which shows the circulation of blood in human heart. After this, please try and understand this. I'm going to compare with the time of circulation in other animals also. Let's compare it. I just told you that there are babies in whom we say that they have a small pore somewhere in their heart. That may be somewhere here. Due to which what happens is that this impure blood gets mixed with the pure blood. And this mixing we cannot afford. We are complex organisms and we need complete good supply of oxygen. If the blood to be supplied to the whole body has a mixture of impure blood in it, carbon dioxide in it, and not purified oxygen, then the cells will not get the oxygen required by them and the body will start turning blue. This is the reason why these babies will face that problem, and in that case, what will happen? Either the poor baby here in the wall, between auricle and ventricle, between the right side and the left side of the heart, or in this wall also there may be some problem. So accordingly, the problems are sorted out. Yes, medical science has advanced enough to take very good care of all these problems. In case of humans, the blood is flowing in this way. And in case of the lower organisms, the chambers of heart are different. We are going to compare them also, but let's understand it first of all. This I told you that the way the blood goes this way, going out and then coming back and then coming here and then going to the body. This is actually the series. Now how the heart basically pumps. See, this is the upper side and this is the lower. Okay? Upper side of the heart squeezes, contracts, and pours the blood in the lower side, and the lower side basically expands to receive it. And there, once it squeezes, the upper part expands. This is how the heart basically expands and contracts. That means this, of course, is the circulation of blood from where to where blood is going, agreed. But how my heart is pumping? The first sound, in Hindi we call it as dhak dhak. In English we say lap dap. What is that sound? The first sound, because see, by the time I'm speaking this to you n number of times, my heart has already beaten as well as yours. But one single, that means the whole expression that I have done, this right auricle to ventricle, then this and this, whole of it, it takes, we call this cardiac cycle. Cardiac cycle, L-U-P-D-U-V, lapped up. Okay, when in that case, remember always that once these sounds are produced, these sounds basically are the result of the valves, the closure of valves. The first sound comes once the heart squeezes or contracts from the upper side, and these two eight valves, they shut down. After filling the lower cavity, these two walls, they shut down, they produce the first sound. The second sound, these are going to squeeze now, the lower ones are going to squeeze. When the lower ones squeeze, the blood will fill in here. pulmonary artery and aorta. When these two are sending, the semilunar walls present here, they are going to close or shut down. And that sound is actually the second sound. This whole process that I had explained to you is actually known as one cardiac cycle. And in case of humans, this one cardiac cycle takes 0.8 seconds. Just imagine how small of this time. In 0.8 seconds, one cardiac cycle completes. That means this whole story. Also, blood coming and going and coming, like this double circulation we are saying now in the heart, it takes only and only 0.8 seconds. Cardiac cycle. So, in this case, remember, first step, when the atriums or the auricles contract, the blood goes from right auricle and left auricle to right ventricle and left ventricle. Right auricle to right ventricle, left auricle to left ventricle. Okay. Now, once the lower side, it starts expanding and this one starts squeezing. The blood should not go back up. To avoid that, the upper AV walls are going to shut down. And the lower parts, once it squeezes, the ventricle squeeze and the blood is sent to the lungs and to the body parts. So, this is how the heart basically then expand. This is the way it goes. And between this cardiac cycle, for fraction of seconds, whole of the chambers, they come in expanded state completely, once in every cardiac cycle, for fraction of seconds. Out of that 0.8 also, there is small juncture wherein all the heart is at the expanded state. Well, that is the advanced study of it. Sticking to this, that is there in our syllabus. Yeah, cardiac cycle, 0.8 seconds. Circulation of blood in human heart this way, no mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated. Otherwise, it will be very, very harmful for the human beings. And in that case, what happens? The next one also we are supposed to understand. This is one question. The second one also, the first one is also that it is going to go this way, the circulation. We are supposed to draw the ray diagram. The second one you are supposed to keep in mind is that they may ask you about the double circulation. And third, of course, because the time in today's lecture we have already taken up. Now, next part I'll be dealing, that is the heart chambers in various organisms, I'll be taking up in the next class. What I meant to say over here is that please remember the terms. And whenever you are writing this, please write down the full form of it. Okay? So, with that, we come to the end of today's lecture, and that is what the circulation of blood in human heart. Please try to read it, and if there are any doubts, you can ask me. Happy learning, kids. Take care.